Hello, everyone. My name is Reverend Dr. Renee Hart. I am an independent minister. I am a licensed practitioner for Center for Spiritual Living in Redlands. Our Reverend is Reverend Carey. And so today we're going to do meditation. So let's just sit back and enjoy this Sunday. Beautiful meditation. So we're just going to sit back and move your arms and neck and just relax. And knowing God is all that it is. So as we take this God breath, we breathe. And we're knowing God is the courser. And so as we're moving into meditation, open up the heart space. Let go and let God do the rest. So picture yourself bathing in God's love all around you. Picture God's spirit is within you and the loving kindness is moving through you as you today. So let's take that breath and take another breath and breathe. Breathe again. Knowing that there's only one life. That life is God's life. That life is perfect. And that life is my life now. There's only one life. That life is God's life. That life is perfect. That life is my life now. Breathe. continue to just breathe. As we take this breath, we breathe and knowing God is at the core center of being. As we take this God breath, we bring our awareness back into this room, to the space where we are. Fully alert, fully aware of where you are. As we take this God breath, we breathe, move your head from side to side. Know all is well. Know all is in divine right order today. God bless you. Namaste. This concludes our meditation.
Take a look at the person next to you. Say, God loves you and I love you too. Feel the love in a sanctuary. Now lift your voice and repeat after me. We come together. We come together. We come together. In the name of love. We come together. Next to you, say, I recognize the God in you. Feel the love in a sanctuary. Now lift your voice and repeat after me. We come together. We come together. We come together. In the name of love, we come together. Every walk of life, every creed and color, in kinship we unite, in honor of the God in each other, yeah. Now look at the person next to you. Bow to you. Feel the love in the sanctuary. Now lift your voice and repeat after me. We come together. Yeah, we come together. Oh, we come together. In the name of love, we come together. Yeah, we come together. Oh, we come together. Oh, we come together. Yeah, we come together. In the name of, yeah, we come together.
Hello, I am Edward Fulyun. This week's topic, Better Together, is suggested by the Diversity Inclusion Commission of Centers for Spiritual Living. Our teaching, The Science of Mind, states that there is one presence that is the source of all. And based on this, we say that oneness is the central principle of our metaphysical teaching, and everything else that we teach develops out of that. It's like a puzzle. One space, which implies that I am where you are and you are where I am, which is the reasoning for why we can pray affirmatively for each other. We say there is only one time, this present moment, endlessly unfolding. Only one being, you and me, both part of the great whatever it is. And the puzzle is this. One means no other when we're talking in absolute terms. And yet that oneness shows itself in an endless variety of forms, and we call that diversity. And we see it as a valuable and necessary part of creation, something to be celebrated, explored, integrated. We are one, not because we are the same, but because we share the same source. And together, we create something stronger than what we can do when we are apart. The creators of this week's content give us a beautiful image of wire rope that begins with a single strand that could be as small as 0.6 millimeters in diameter. And then the first step is to wind several of these small wires together, and with each additional strand, a greater and greater strength develops until there is a rope that is capable of so much. Now, any single strand of wire is perfectly good, and when integrated and wrapped around others, it becomes something mighty. In the same way, our inclusion of more and different cultures and views and individual expressions makes us stronger, better together.
Thank you. announcements for us this morning. First, I want to remind you that on Wednesday night from 7 to 8 p.m., our practitioners put on a beautiful meditation service, and we have wonderful uplifting messages from them as well. So we would love to have you join us from 7 to 8 p.m. every Wednesday night on Facebook Live. And then on Thursday mornings on Zoom, we have our book club at 10:30 in the morning. And in our book club, we have decided to study the 1938 edition of The Science of Mind. It starts with the chapter, The Thing Itself. So we would love to have you join us at our book club, 10:30 in the morning, read the chapter, The Thing Itself, and come join a lively discussion, 10:30 Thursday morning. Next Sunday, Brother Mark is gonna be our guest speaker. He's not really a guest either. He's one of us and a wonderful presenter. So you'll enjoy his message, I know, and you'll enjoy the music from Cahill and Deline. It'll be a wonderful Sunday, so please do attend next Sunday morning and listen to an inspiring message from Brother Mark. And then on September 21st, that's a Monday, from 1 to 2 p.m., we are participating in a global meditation for peace. This is happening through many, many churches around the world. This will happen from 1 to 2 p.m. at our center, and we are doing it on Facebook Live, the safe way. Our practitioners are participating in this, and I'd love to have you join us on Facebook Live. That's Monday, September 21st from 1 to 2 p.m. And you can probably also catch that on YouTube. I thank you for your participation today and for being here. Thank you for being who you are.
So as we take this breath, we breathe. And just knowing right here, right now, right where you are, God is. Knowing that God's Spirit is moving in you, through you, and all around you as I speak. So as we take this breath, we breathe and knowing all is well. All is in divine right order, right here, right now, within you. Because we know that that Christ consciousness is moving and growing within you right now. Knowing that you are whole, healthy, and complete. I know this for you. We bless this day. This day is the day that the Lord has made, and we are truly blessed in this moment. And so as we are blessed, we're knowing in this very moment that God is, of course, center of everywhere, everything. And so as we take this God breath, we're knowing that that power, that seed is within us. And so as we take this breath right here, right now, we breathe in loving kindness, knowing that all is perfect, all is well, all is perfect, all is well. And so in this, I give thanks for this truth. I give thanks for knowing that all is in the divine right order. I give thanks for this and so much more. And I just release my words into this universal law. And I know that it is perfect, and I know it's complete. We'll sing, and so it is. Amen. God bless, and I'll see you soon.
Sometimes in our lives, We all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if I have things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs that you won't let show. Lean on me when you're not strong, I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just lean on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you understand. We all need somebody to lean on me. Yeah, when you're not strong, I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there is a load you have to bear that you can't carry, I'm right up the road, I'll share your load if you just call me. You just call me if you need a friend. Call me, oh yeah, call me when you need a friend. Call me, I'll be right there. Call me, yeah, call me, won't you call me.
Good morning and happy Sunday. We are here today to continue our study of inclusion in action, which is this month's theme from Centers for Spiritual Living. And today we're going to talk about how we are better together. Always, always. You know, it's been said that if God wanted us to be alone in the world, we'd have our own planet, something like that. But we're all on one planet for a reason. We're here to be here together, to allow ourselves to enjoy life together. And today, I want to talk about including life, including the presence of God, including all things into our life. So today what I want to do is just focus on the idea that we are stronger together in every way. You know, a wire rope begins with a single steel wire that's anywhere from 6/10 to 8 millimeters in diameter. That's pretty little. So that all of these wires wound into a strand form a strong rope for the task that they're going to do. And we, my friends, are like that strand of steel wire. We are just one strand in this whole complex of humanity. We can take care of anything when we do it together, because putting all of our talents and all of our strength and all of our skills into one place helps us to be of service. It helps us to express the life that is God more completely. It is a way for us to include all of the beautiful cultures and views and individualized expressions of God. There's strength in numbers. We've heard that before, of course. And when we come together to bring ourselves into a greater strength, then our community is far more effective. And I'm talking about the community within our family, the community within our church, any organization, or the community at large throughout the world. We're stronger together. And today, what we need to remember is that when we are in a creative process, like we are right now in our world, we include various elements to bring about a strength that will carry us forward. We need all of the elements of nature in order to create whatever it is that we desire. And once they all come together in that beautiful universal organizational pattern, then we have what we have created. We can see it. Everything that is created comes from the invisible. We come from the invisible. There are invisible elements within our physical being that have come together, vibrating at a lower density so that we can be seen. Wow. We are the invisible energy of the divine. We are that. And when we bring other invisible energies of the divine into our circle, we are making our spirituality, we're making our strength, we're making our lives far more magnificent than they ever could be by ourselves. And then there is the evolution of the creation that we've made. Some time ago, my late husband and I bought a pickup truck and a fifth wheel trailer. Now the trailer was probably, 20 feet long, maybe 16 feet, I don't know. And we had a regular old pickup truck and we loved that trailer. We had more fun going camping and taking trips. And we had created that because of our desire to do just that. And then our creation evolved. And we knew that we wanted a larger truck and a larger fifth wheel trailer. So we ended up with a Dually diesel Ford truck and a 30-foot trailer. And it was magnificent. Our idea of what we wanted evolved. And that's what happens when we take the creative process, bring it together with all of those invisible elements, with our power, with the power of our mind, and we bring together the creation that we desire. It evolves, because as humans, we are always evolving into more life, more abundance, more joy, more health, more peace. We're always evolving, and so our creations are also evolving. But the thing is, we have to remember that every time we create something, we are in action in inclusivity. We are inclusion in action, because if we excluded certain parts of our desire, said, oh, I want this, but I don't want that, well, it wouldn't turn out exactly like we would expect. We need to be inclusive in our life and embrace all things that are for our highest good. And if they're not, we'll see it. And we can move on to our next creation. It's a fun process to play on this planet. So I invite you to do so abundantly. A tapestry fabric is woven by weaving horizontal threads up and under vertical threads, and then squishing them down so that they're close together, and they form a beautiful tapestry or a beautiful piece of cloth. We are each a part of the one big energy organism, a tapestry, if you will, that expresses and experiences itself as the divine in form, which is us. We are the invisible elements of nature in form as a human being. We are the invisible elements of nature in form as a human being. Yes. Do you realize that inclusion is how we are created? Inclusion allows us to be born into this beautiful planet so that we can experience and play in life. We are inclusive beings. And as we learn more about including others, as we learn more about including ourselves and including all of life, we bring more and more and more expressions of God into life, into our life, into the life of others. But sometimes we need to take the time to learn how to do that. Wow, inclusion is so natural for us, and yet through our country's history, there has been exclusion to the point that there is now a division. So it's time for us to bring inclusion, that natural state of inclusion, back into our daily life. It's, if you think about it, inclusion is actually an illusion without the proper supports, without the education, without a learning process about how we can include other people in our lives. And I noticed that over the last 30, 40 years, we have been learning little bits and pieces about how to be inclusive and really bringing ourselves into an acceptance of people who are different than us. The other day, my daughter and I were at the grocery store, and there was a gentleman coming down the aisle, and he was pushing his cart very slowly. He was older than I am. I was going to say elderly, but none of us are elderly, but in the physical form, he was older than I and a bit stooped over and walking very slowly. And bless his heart, he was just doing the best he could. And my daughter and I stopped and just asked him, how are you doing? And he said, just fine. You see, that's inclusion. That tiny act is inclusion. And that conversation might have meant the world to that man. I know people who are so good at that, that it's a natural instinct. And then there are those of us who hesitate to talk to strangers because it's been beaten into our head since we were little kids. It's time for us to be inclusive in every aspect of our life. There is a wonderful story that I want to tell you about a little girl named Brittany. Her mother wrote this story in a blog and didn't give her name or any of the details about where they lived. But Brittany was a child with classic autism. She was nonverbal. She was profoundly impaired with her receptive skills. She had severe sensory and social impairments. She had OCD that was off the chart, said her mother, and all the other bells and whistles that come with classic autism. She was a perfect fit for a small, self-contained classroom somewhere in the school district, but fate and circumstances had other plans. As we know, we make plans and God laughs. Brittany ended up in an amazing, well-orchestrated inclusion model that took her from kindergarten all the way through high school. Now, this model included a one-on-one mentor or helper. Her mother called her a guardian angel. And this person stayed with Brittany through all of her schooling in every class, every day, three schools, elementary, middle, and high school. And she was her one-on-one tutor, basically, and helped Brittany in the classroom. Now, Brittany loved where she was and what she was doing. And she was given a modified curriculum, and this helped her placement be doable and successful. And once in a while, they had to tweak her program. But what was so wonderful is that the peers around her, her fellow students, helped her in countless ways. And their presence in her life helped her develop social and coping skills that, of course, became invaluable to her as she grew. And the other students were never asked to modify their behavior to meet Brittany's autistic limitations, but they were asked to really come from their heart and do what they felt was right in that moment. And of course, they were instructed by her guardian angel and her teachers. All of the students were guided in how they could best assist Brittany and be her friend. There was a little bit of an educational piece there for them. So even with Brittany's vast differences, the kids accepted her and included her and loved her for exactly who she was. They constantly treated her with kindness, and they understood and they accepted her. And she got to participate in every class trip, all the PE classes, all in her own unique way. And then she graduated from high school. Now her mentor offered to walk with her if Brittany wanted her to, but also said if you'd rather have one of your friends walk with you, that's okay too. And so Brittany and one of her friends walked in graduation, and Brittany completed a successful mainstream educational program. Because she was different, she wasn't set aside in a classroom when she was young to just kind of do what she was supposed to do as an autistic kid and really not get an education. But this way, her education was so inclusive of many, many friends and lots of people and subjects. And the things that she learned went far beyond the educational system that is in our schools. And her mother wrote, "Brittany's inclusion was a perfect storm of timing, people, and circumstances. She wrote, "The planets aligned for my beautiful girl." What if we, as the planets on this planet, would align and be inclusive and accepting and understanding of not only other people, but of ourselves? What if we allowed ourselves the educational opportunities to learn more about ourselves, to learn more about the divine, to take one of our Science of Mind classes, for instance? Foundation class is going right now, and the discussions we are having are so rich and so beautiful. And if you have never taken one of those classes, I invite you to do so, because that, my friends, is also being inclusive, and it's an inclusive way for you to grow and expand your soul and allow yourself to really live a truly magnificent life. Be inclusive to yourself. Be inclusive to others. Nona Brooks is the founder of Divine Science years ago, and she wrote in her book, Mysteries, on page 117, she wrote this: "Since unity is the basic principle of universal expression, let us base our living, our thinking, and our doing upon this law of unity. When we live true to this law, the hard experiences of life, of the external, pass away, and our days grow restful, free, and full of joy. That which we experience in the spirit of unity cannot limit us." We are unlimited when we experience God in unity. And God is where? Yes, God is everywhere, in every person, in every speck of nature. And if we allow ourselves to experience all of this life in that unity, we are unlimited and unbound. I have an affirmation for you today, of course. We're going to speak it together. The words will be on your screen. Here we go. I am the activity of inclusion. I embrace the multiplicity of creation as a community expressing divinity on earth. And so it is. Blessings.
Love is but a song we sing. Fear's the way we die. You can make the mountains ring or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing and you may not know why. Come on, people, now smile. Some may come and some may go. This will surely pass. turns for us at last. We are but a moment's sunlight fading in the grass. Come on, people now, smile on your brother. Everybody get together, try to love. If you hear the song I sing, you will understand. Listen. You hold the key to love and fear all in your trembling hand. Just one key unlocks the try to love one another right now. Come on, people now, smile out your brother. Everybody get together, try to love one another right now. Right now, right
Hi, I'm Becky Price, and I'm a member of the Center for Spiritual Living in Redlands. What I love about religious science and why I keep coming is the real fellowship and support of each other, especially in these times. And it's we follow, we learn, we use five steps for spiritual affirmation. So when I come to the church, I always know that people there are all working on themselves, their consciousness, their ability to embrace and use and express love. And that is really, really awesome. It's a very gentle teaching. It just goes on and on. There's many classes to take. There's many service positions to fill. And so I'm really grateful. I also follow the 12 steps, the 12-step recovery. And I'm grateful that, you know, that's part of my reality and that is a big part of me. And so is religious science. They really, like, coexist. It really works together. But I'm grateful that I get to, I was asked what is my feeling about religious science and about Redlands Church, which is I love, and it's always in recovery. It's always in getting back what God made us to be. That's all. Thank you. Bye.
We've come to the time in our service to give back to our spiritual nourishment. This is where we give our tithes, our gifts, and our offerings to that place that provides us with spiritual nourishment. I know that you love supporting the Center for Spiritual Living in Redlands, California, and we appreciate your gift so much. And I want you to know that we would really appreciate it if you would give on a regular basis so that we can truly plan our financial obligations and getting them taken care of. We want to invite you to look to the right of the video on Facebook, if you're watching us on Facebook, to see the words "See More" in bold and click on that. You will see opportunities and ways to give to our center. You'll see that at the very top link is for PayPal. You can click on that and it'll take you right to PayPal. Under that is a link for Venmo. Under that is information about giving using Zelle. And under that is our mailing address. You can write a check, put your check in the mail, or you can bring your check in an envelope and place it in our secure mailbox on the parking lot side of our building. We so appreciate the support that you always give. And I know that as you give, you receive abundantly. So let's take our gift in our hand. And if you've already given today, we thank you for that. Just imagine that gift there. And if you have your gift with you, put it in your hand. And if you like, put it over your heart. And let's repeat our offering affirmation together. From the love of pure spirit within me, I bless this gift. I send it forth to heal and bless and prosper. It is evidence of my faith and my belief. It does great work in the world and returns to me multiplied abundantly. And so it is.
So now I invite you to join us for our closing affirmative prayer. And so if you are a practitioner or minister at home and you would like to rise, I encourage you to rise and join us in the two or more gathered consciousness where we know that we know that we know. And so inviting everybody now within the sound of my voice to allow for your exhale to release everything that's in the human. As we take in our next breath, that is a divine breath, we inhale the divine. And we exhale out everything that's preceded this moment in time. And we inhale in the divine. And exhaling out anything that has preceded this moment that might be stuck in the human, that might be causing us to be fully present, just release that with our exhale. And when you're comfortable, just simply allow for your outer eyes to close. Returning to our normal breathing pattern, inviting you to allow for the inner eyes to open. And when we allow for our inner eyes to open, some call it the third eye, we see rightly, we see divinely. We see that there's only the omnipresence of good, there's only the omnipresence of God, that God is everywhere present and right where I am. God is everywhere present and right where you are. And it is from this place of unity and oneness and unification that I speak this word of blessing this day. And so I call forth for divine right action to be the order of the day for each of us individually and for all of us collectively. I call forth for any obstacles that have heretofore blocked or hindered or deferred or denied or delayed your highest vibration for your highest and best good. Let anything that has tried to stop you have no more real power. Let it slip away just like the raindrops to the ground. See it vanquish or vanish just like the shower or bath water goes down the drain, never again to surface and reappear. And instead be replaced with the spiritual truth that God is at hand, that life is at hand, that the universe always says yes for my highest and best good and for your highest and best good. I know this to be true, and I know this to be so. And so I continue to see each of you individually and all of us collectively hermetically sealed in divine health, perfect wholeness, and divine right action right here and right now. I call it forth, I name it and proclaim it and affirm it. I call forth for cash and money and abundance and wealth and divine right employment and divine right housing to reach each of us and all of us who need those things right here and right now with no delay, for there's no delay in spirit. There's nothing to do in spirit. There's only to be. There's only to allow. And so I call forth for the grace of God to have its way through all sentient beings right here and right now. I call forth for miracles to look ordinary right here and right now. I declare and affirm that only good can come from every single situation. And so I feel good about the word spoken. I rest on this rock of truth and shall not be moved nor swayed from this place. Knowing that this prayer is a living word, it can be breathed into at any point in time in the future and remembered and recalled and reactivated and regenerated and restored and be made new again to have just as much power as it has right here and right now. For it is not my power. It is the power of the living God within me that speaks this word to the law of life, which only knows to say yes. And so with a grateful heart, I surrender my word to the law. I know it is done. I know it is perfect. I know it is complete. I know that God knows, that Spirit knows, that any other words that I may have wanted or needed even to say have been said. Yes, 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 by Spirit, who made us each individually whole, complete, and perfect, and knows every strand on our head, and knows that all of our needs are to be met right here, right now, and forevermore. On time, every time. And so I'm grateful for this. I'm grateful for this word. I let it be so. And invite you to say together with me, and so it is.
Let me know that love can heal us all.
serve in a holy, holy way. Let me serve, let me serve in a holy, holy way. Let me serve in a holy, holy way. Let me serve, let me serve in a holy, holy way. Oh, let me share the good that's overflowing. Let me share the good that's overflowing. And let me care for those around the world. Oh, let me serve in a holy, holy way. Oh, let me serve in a holy, holy way. Oh, let me serve in a holy, holy way. Oh, let me serve in a holy, holy way. Oh, let me live in a holy, holy way. Let me live in a holy, holy way. And let me love in a holy, holy way. Let me love, let me
And so now that our Sunday experience has concluded, you're invited to join us in the Zoom room by following the links and the instructions that you'll see. So it's simple. Just come on in and say hi. You can turn on your video, you can see others, you can hear others, and check in and connect. We're usually in the Zoom room following our Sunday service for about 30 minutes or so. So come on in, say hello. Know that you're never alone. You're always loved. You're always completely sourced, supplied, and maintained by the power and the presence, the love, and the grace of God.